Good morning, students. In my last class, we were doing Act 3, Scene 2, in which we were going through Bassanio's dialogue, wherein Bassanio was explaining to Portia about himself. Wherein he told Portia about himself that he bragged about himself, saying that he was worth for nothing. But actually, he says that he's worse than anything. That is what actually he means about himself. That he has hidden, he says. So that is what he says, that he was just bragging, worth for nothing. He said, actually, I should have said that I am worse than anything. This is what he says in the. This is what we heard from Bassanio in the last class, right? So then let us move to the next part of the particular dialogue. That was that I was worse than nothing, for indeed I have engaged myself to a dear friend. So he says, I have engaged, in the sense I have borrowed money from one of my dearest friend. So here he is telling about his friend Antonio, right? So he says, I have engaged myself to a dear friend. Engage my friend to his mere enemy. And that friend of mine, is speaking about Antonio, that friend of mine who in turn borrowed money from a mortal enemy, from his mortal enemy. He in turn borrowed money from a mortal enemy of his. Engage my friend to his mere enemy. So I engage myself. I borrowed money from my dear friend, and my dear friend borrowed money from his mortal enemy. This is what he says. To feed my means, that too for me, for my sake, he borrowed money from his mortal enemy, he says. Here is a letter, lady. The paper has the body of my friend, and every word in it is a gaping wound issuing life blood. So he's showing the letter. He's showing the letter to Portia, and he says, here is the letter, lady. So here the letter is, lady, he says, to Portia. The paper is the body of my friend, and this paper is like the body of my friend, which is wounded, the wounded body of my friend. That is what he's saying. And every word in it is a gaping wound, and every word in this particular paper is like a bleeding wound. It's not just a wound, it is like a bleeding wound, and every word in it is like a bleeding wound issuing life blood on that body, right? And which is pouring out blood. Every wound on his body is pouring out blood. This is what he says. But is it true, Salario? Had all his ventures failed? What, not one hit? So he's asking Salario, is it true, Salario, that all his ships are wrecked? All, not even one is successful? Not even one is success? That is what he's asking over here. Salario, hath all his ventures failed? All his merchandise have failed, he's asking. What, not one hit? Not even one is success, he's asking him. From Tripolis, from Mexico and England, is asking. He had all ships which had gone to these places. One ship went to Tripolis, the other was in Mexico, and another one England, another one Lisbon, another one Barbary, and another India. And like this, all the ships are wrecked. So it's a strange thing, isn't it? All these ships which were in different places, were all they wrecked? Did he lose from all these ships? That is what he's asking him. And not one vessel escaped the dreadful touch of merchant marine rocks. And none of these ships which went escaped from those rocks, from those dangerous rocks. Okay, those rocks are been called over here, rocks that ruin merchants by wrecking their ships. That is what has been called as merchant marine rocks, right? Merchant marine rocks means rocks that ruin merchants by wrecking their ships. So all these ships which went to all these places are all wrecked, he's asking. None of the ships have escaped from these rocks, he's asking him. Fine. So on this, Salario's reply, let us see what Salario replies on this. Not one, my lord. Besides, it should appear that if he had the present money to discharge the Jew, he would not take it. Never did I know a creature that did bear the shape of man, so keen and greedy to confound a man. He plies the Duke at morning and at night, and doth impeach the freedom of the state. If they deny him justice, 20 merchants, the Duke himself, and the magnificers of greatest port have all persuaded associated with him, but none can drive him from the envious plea of forfeiture of justice and his bond. So this is what Salarius says. Salarius says, not even one escaped, not even one of the ships came back, and not even one of his business ventures is successful. This is what he says over here. My lord, he says, besides, it should appear that if he had the present money to discharge the Jew, he would not take it. So he says, even if he had money right now, besides that, forget about the ships. From the ships, he lost everything. Besides that, even if Antonio was having money with him, and if that money was given to that Jew would have not taken that money. This is what he says. The Jew would have not taken the money, wouldn't have taken it. This is what the present money to discharge the Jew, to give the Jew. Okay, if he would have had some money with us, left with Antonio, and he would have given it to the Jew, he would have not taken it. He would not take it. Never did I know a creature that did bear the shape of man. I have never seen such a creature. So he is calling the Jew, that is, he's calling Shylock as a creature over here. That is what he's saying. I have never in my life seen such a creature, he says. Okay, such a creature that did bear the shape of a man, that too. Such a creature who has taken the shape of a man, the shape of a human being, like this Shylock. This is what he says. Okay. So keen and greedy to confound a man. He is so keen. He is so absolute and very much greedy to destroy a man. Look at this creature. He is a real devil. That is what he is indicating over here, right? So he plies the Duke at morning and at night. He is at the Duke's place. Right from morning to night, morning and night, he keeps on visiting the Duke's place. This is what he says. And doth impeach the freedom of the state, accusing the state of harming free trade, of which he denies his justice. Okay, he need justice, he says. Okay, so every time, why he is appearing to the Duke? To complain about Antonio, that he needs justice. He need justice. Justice in the sense, he don't want money now. He want the flesh of Antonio. So this is what he require over here. And with that condition, he keeps on visiting the Duke, speaking about the injustice which took place in his life. And the injustice is terming it in this manner, right? So this is what he says. And doth impeach the freedom of the state. So he wants justice to be done over there. And if they are not giving him justice, he is asking for justice. He wants justice, he says. If they are denying for it, then he says, then he is accusing the state of harming free trade. Okay, so this is what he says over here. And with that condition, he is appearing to the Duke every now and then. That is why he said morning and night, he is there at the Duke's place asking for this. So, and doth impeach the freedom of the state. If they deny him justice, 20 merchants, the Duke himself and the Magnificus of greatest port have all persuaded with him. So, 20 merchants. So, at about 20 merchants, at the Duke and the Magnificus. Magnificus means the highest ranking Venetian nobleman. The highest ranking Venetian nobleman. That is what it has been said. Magnificus of greatest port. Magnificus of the greatest port means the highest ranking Venetians nobleman are being spoken about. So these people and those 20 merchants and the Duke himself, they all tried to convince Shylock, saying that to forget about that contract. But do you think Shylock will agree? No, never he agrees. That is what you can see. But none can drive him from the envious plea to say he is determined to get the penalties. Okay, the penalties specified. He is very much determined to get the penalty specified. So he won't agree to these persuading words of those people mentioned here. Okay. Of forfeiture of justice and his bond. So he is specified in his contract with Antonio. He says nothing doing, that he want justice, and they all told him. These 20 merchants, Magnificus and the Duke himself, all these people together told him, see, Shylock, just forget about it. Leave it. So they convinced him, they persuaded this man, but he didn't accept it. He didn't agree with it. He said that he wants whatever he has to. Antony has to pay the penalty. The contract, whatever penalty is specified in the contract, it has to go the way it is mentioned in the contract, according to Shylock. So this is the plight over here. Now you can see. Fine. Now let us see. Now Jessica is speaking about it. Let us see what she says about it. When I was with him, I have heard him swear to Tubal and to Cus, his countrymen, that he would rather have Antonio's flesh than 20 times the value of the sum that he did owe him. And I know, my lord, if law, authority and power deny not, it will go hard with poor Antonio. So here Jessica says, Jessica is not in favor of her father. She is also against her father. And this is what she says. When I was with him, when I was still living with him, with my father, with Shylock, she says, I have heard him swear to Tubal. I heard him speaking this to Tubal and to Cus. He was speaking this to Tubal and to another man, right? So Cus, so his countryman, so both other two Jews, he was discussing this matter. And what was he discussing? That he would rather have Antonio's flesh than 20 times the value of the sum. So he would prefer having Antonio's flesh than having 20 times the value of the sum. Even if Antonio is ready to pay 20 times the amount what he has to really pay to him, he was not ready to accept that amount, but he was ready to take the flesh of Antonio. This is what it is said. Then 20 times the value of the sum that he did owe him. So whatever Antonio has to give him, you know, Antonio owes him to pay. Then 20 times of that amount also he was not ready to take. In fact, he was ready to take the flesh of Antonio. This is what you can see. And I know, my lord, if law, authority and power deny not, if law, authority do not prevent it, then it is going to be bad time for poor Antonio. This is what she says. Okay. If law and authorities, law, authority, power, if they are not going to prevent this, then Antonio is going to face a bad situation. It is going to be a bad case for Antonio. This is what she tells about her father. So Portia interferes. Portia says, is it your dear friend that is thus in trouble? So she's asking Bassanio, is this your good friend who is in trouble, who is in so much trouble, she says over here. So Bassanio says, the dearest friend to me, the kindest man, the best condition and unwearied spirit in doing courtesies, and one in whom the ancient Roman honor more appears than any that draws breath in Italy. So he says, the dearest friend to me, yes, he is my best friend. Antonio is my best friend. Bassanio says, the kindest man is kindest man, the best conditioned and unwary. Best condition means good natured, most willing, kindest person. Okay, so this is what he is appreciating about his friend Antonio Bassanio. So you can understand one thing over here. After getting all the wealth, after getting Portia, he didn't forget his friend Antonio. He was very thankful and he in fact is helping out. He was worried about his friend Antonio, because whatever Antonio is suffering is because of Bassanio. He still remembers it and he too is willing to help him in return. That is what you can understand from here. So true friendship. So the theme of true friendship you can see in all these. We had seen from Antonio's side in the earlier scenes, and now we are seeing the friendship of Bassanio, how he repays that friendship. You can see over here, right? Best condition and unwearied. So he says, good natured friend of mine, he's my best friend and most willing friend to do anything for me. That is what he's trying to say. And unwearied, untiring, he's never tiring, he will do anything. That is what we had seen, isn't it? First he had given some amount as loan for Bassanio and he didn't return it, but he was not worried about it. Second loan also he gave when Bassanio asked, right? That is what you can see. In doing courtesies, and one in whom the ancient Roman honor more appears than any that draws breath in Italy. So you can see over here, and one in whom, in doing courtesies, and one in whom means he's the one most courteous person. Most courteous person to all others. That is what has been said over here. The ancient Roman honor. So the one whom the ancient Roman honor more appears. He is more honorable. That is what has been said. Is more honorable. Is more honorable than any that draws breath in Italy. Than anyone else in Italy. That is what it has been said. He is more honorable than anyone else in Italy. So he is one. The ancient Roman honor means loyalty to friends and countrymen. Okay. And to the country, you can see. So he is such a person. He is not only good to one individual, but he is courteous to all, others. This is what it has been said. Loyalty to friends as well as to the country. A loyal person, a very loyal person. That is what his loyalty is shown to the to his friends as well as to the country. This is what it has been said. So he is more honorable than anyone else in Italy. He is much more honorable than anybody else in Italy. So Portia says, what sum owes he the Jew? So Portia is asking, how much does he owe to the Jew? He asks, she is asking over here. So Bassanio says, for me, 3,000 ducats. So he has to give 3,000 ducats to Shylock, and that too on my behalf. Bassanio says, on my behalf, he has to pay 3,000 ducats. This is what Bassanio says.